What is dimensioning? Why it is needed? How to do dimensioning? What are the methods? Do you know the principles of dimensioning? To learn the answers for these questions, watch this video completely without skipping in the middle. The purpose of dimensioning is to provide a clear and complete description of an object. This is provided in the form of size and location of features. Size means length, width, height, etc. Location means position of a feature like a hole with reference to other object or surface or edge, etc. Apart from this, other details like kind of finish, type of material, etc. are also need in the case of production drawings. These features are illustrated on a drawing by the use of lines, symbols, figures, and notes called dimensioning. Diagram shows a rectangular prism with a vertical hole drilled in its center. Now, let us see how to do dimensioning. Diagram shows the front view of the rectangular prism. Here, rectangular prism is the object. So, the lines used to draw the object are called object lines. They should be thick. Next, we will dimension the length of the object. You can do it either above the object or below the object. We choose to do above the object. For better understanding, instead of taking the object, I am taking the top edge of the object to do dimensioning. The dimension line should be thin and consist of arrowheads on both ends of the line. It also consists of a dimension text which represents the size of the object line. Here, it represents the length of the object line, that is 100 mm. The length of the line should not be longer than or shorter than the object line. Its length must be equal to the object line. To make it happen, you have to follow two conditions. First condition, draw extension lines at the end of the object line, which are perpendicular to the object line. Second condition, draw dimension line always parallel to the object line. Usually, 10 mm gap should be maintained between the dimension line and the object line. Also, extension lines should extend above 3 mm beyond the dimension line. Also, arrowheads should be kept inside the extension lines up to 10 mm. When it exceeds, arrowheads should be placed outside the extension lines. There are many types of arrowheads. This is an open arrowhead. This one is closed arrowhead. Third one is closed and filled arrowhead. This is dot type. The last one is oblique stroke. Among the five, the most popular and widely used one is closed and filled arrowhead. There is a BIS standard to draw the arrowhead. Its width to length ratio is 1:3. If its width is taken as x, then its length is 3x. It should be an isosceles triangle. Some students have been drawing the arrowhead like an equilateral triangle. Never draw this shape. Figure shows the right half sectional front view of a rectangular block having a central vertical hole and two fins at the left end. Leader line can be used to indicate the name of the object. For this purpose, leader line uses a normal triangular arrowhead at its end that touches the outline of the object. The object is sectioned on the right side, so that portion is hatched. To indicate the sectional area, leader line's one end is kept inside the hatched portion. Whenever leader line moves inside the object, it uses dot instead of arrowhead. Oblique stroke can be used wherever dimensional space is too small. Leader line can also be used at this place to write the dimension text conveniently. But in this case, leader line has a plain end. It doesn't hold any arrowhead or dot. Methods of indicating dimensions. Dimension texts should be indicated on a drawing according to one of the following two methods. They are 1. Aligned system, 2. Unidirectional system. However, only one method should be used on any one drawing. What is aligned system? Dimension text should be placed parallel to their dimension lines and preferably near the middle and above the dimension line. Dimension text may be written so that they can be read from the bottom or from the right side of the drawing. Dimension text on oblique or inclined dimension lines should be oriented as shown in figure. Angular dimensions may be oriented as shown in figure. The same viewing rule can be applied, that is, either from the bottom or from the right side. What is unidirectional system? Here, dimension text should be always horizontal, irrespective of the orientation of the dimension line. Dimension text should be indicated so that they can be read from the bottom of the drawing only. You can't take it from the right. Non-horizontal dimension lines are broken in the middle for insertion of the dimension text. In horizontal dimension line, as usual, dimension text should be placed above the dimension line. Inserting the text in the middle after breaking the middle portion is also practiced. Arrangement of dimensions. There are 5 types of dimension styles used on drawing. The first one, chain dimensioning. When each single dimension line is placed directly adjacent to the next dimension line without any gap between dimension lines, then that style of dimensioning is called chain dimensioning. That is, the dimension lines are placed in series. Number 2, parallel dimensioning. When many dimension lines are measured in the same direction from a common feature, that is, a surface or an edge of the part, then this method of indicating all the dimensions from the same feature is called parallel dimensioning. The dimension lines are parallel to each other and equally spaced. Number 3, superimposed running dimensioning or progressive dimensioning. The parallel dimension will not be practicable when space is short. In such cases, the dimensions can be used by the simplified method of superimposed running dimensioning. There is a starting point from which dimension lines are placed in series having accumulated dimensions at each end. The starting point, the dimension is taken as 0 and first end, the actual dimension is 150 and the second end is 420. The 420 means from 0 to that second end is 420. That is accumulated dimension. The last one is 640. That is from left to right. 0 to your right end is 640. In this way, at each end point, the dimension is accumulated. Number 4, combined dimensioning. These are the result of simultaneous use of chain and parallel dimensioning. The last one is coordinate dimensioning. Dimensioning by a coordinate table can be used in place of other dimensioning styles. This can be make drawing easier to read when the part would have many dimensions. A good example of using coordinate would be for a plate that has many holes in it. Dimensioning with other dimension styles might make the drawing look overly cluttered. How to do dimensions for circular profiles? Circular profiles diameters should be mentioned with a dimension value preceded by 5. Here you can see the various ways to dimension a circle using its diameter, like 510, 515, 520, 530. 5 means diameter, so diameter 10, diameter 15 and so on. Similarly, circular profiles radii should be dimensioned with a dimensional value preceded by a letter capital R. Here you can see the various ways to dimension an arc using its radius. In radius dimensions, only one arrowhead is used in the dimension line. Let us see some important principles of dimensioning. As far as possible, place the dimensions outside the object. In this diagram, the length of the object is dimensioning inside the object. So, as per the principle, this is wrong. So, to correct this, so take the dimension line outside the object. So, the second one is correct. As far as possible, Object lines should not be used as extension lines for dimensioning. So here the width of the slot is given as 70 mm. So here there is a dimension line which is used to dimension the width of the slot, but which doesn't use any extension line. Only the object lines are used as the extension lines here. That's why, as per the principle, this is wrong. To correct this, use two extension lines which is extended from the object line, and then a dimension line kept outside the object. Now this one is correct. Object line should not be used as a dimension line. And in this object, the height of the object is 55 mm. Here the dimension line is kept on the object line itself. In other words, object line act as a dimension line. So this is wrong. To avoid this, use extension line and then a separate dimension line to do dimensioning. And this one is correct. Center line should not be used as a dimension line. In this object, it represents a triangle, maybe it is a cone, so there is an axis passed towards its center, and the height of the triangle is dimension as 55, and the dimension line is kept over the axis line. So this is wrong, because we are not allowed to use a center line as a dimension line. So that separate the dimension line using the extension lines and place it outside the object and use the axis line separate. Now this one is correct. Dimension line should never cross extension line. So in this object, 100 is one dimension line and 70 is another dimension line. The extension lines used for 70 dimension line have been crossed the 100 dimension line. So as per our principle, this is wrong. So to correct this, keep the major dimensions on outer side, keep the minor dimensions on inner side. Like this. So now you can avoid crossing the dimension line with the extension lines. So this is the correct one. In this, dimension line is not crossed with the extension line. We come to the conclusion, without dimensioning, we can't get a complete description of an object. Even improper dimensioning will lead to wrong interpretations. Actually, what I covered here about dimensioning is not complete, but I think it is sufficient to study engineering graphics. Thank you for watching. Please share this video to your friends. If you want to get more engineering graphics videos, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon.